Hi! Today, we will share a few tips on how to use easing in our animation. I'm sure you have already heard of ease in or ease out. But when I say ease in, does it mean the movement starts slow and ends fast? Or is it the opposite? Well, that depends on if you come from an animation or programming background. Ease means the slow part of a transition. When animators say in or out, they're talking about going into or out of a pose or keyframe. To ease in to a pose, the transition slows just before the pose. To ease out of a pose, the transition slows just after the pose. This makes sense grammatically when you think about it from the perspective of the pose. However, in development, programmers sometimes use easing to refer not to the pose on either side of the transition, but to the transition itself. From that perspective, they assign the opposite meaning that animators use. That is very confusing and should be avoided. As an animator, think about easing into or out of a particular pose. When you want to ease out of a pose and ease into the next pose, that transition is called an easy ease. Let's key this ball at frame 0 and the same pose at frame 10. Next, we jump to frame 30 and move translate X. Separate translate in the tree view, then let's move translate Y and also rotate the ball. Now let's add a key at frame 40 so we have a 10 frame hold at the end of the animation. Keys are set to linear by default, so let's change them to Bezier. We can do this in the dope sheet, graph or curves views. Changing the curves to Bezier already gives us an easy ease by default. An easy ease is that easy. Now let's say we want to significantly slow down the action from frame 20 to 30. There are multiple ways of doing that. Which way you prefer really depends on your own workflow. To do it with the dope sheet, set a key on frame 27, then drag it to frame 20. This gives us an ease in to the next key. This is a technique I use most often when I want what is called a moving hold. A hold is the time between two keys that are the same, so nothing changes. A moving hold is similar, but there is some small movement between the keys. Let's store this animation so we can compare the results. We can also use the favorite tool to get the same result. Go to frame 20 and slide the favorite tool. The slider to the right creates a key that is more similar to the next key than to the previous key. Comparing this to the animation we stored using the dope sheet, you can see how the curve is now overshooting. The easiest way to fix this is to use automatic Bezier curves. This favorite tool technique is what I use most often. Setting automatic Bezier curves and using the favorite tool makes animating very fast and it's definitely worth learning. To reduce the number of clicks required, I use hotkeys for all the different curve types. I also use favorite tool hotkeys to quickly adjust easing. Create the ease in the graph view can be done just like in the dope sheet. Set the key on frame 27, then drag it to frame 20. So far, all of these techniques have resulted in creating an extra key for the ease. Doing that makes it easy to edit the ease. Don't worry about using a few extra keys. You can always go through your animation when it's finished and reduce the number of keys. That said, you can use the graph view to create the easy ease using a single curve by dragging the two handles. Where the handles needs to be is less intuitive than the other methods. Generally, dragging handles around is usually best left until the animation is nearly finished. Time spent micro-adjusting your curves too early becomes wasted if you end up adjusting keys. Lastly, you can use the curves view to create the ease. This is similar to using the graph to make the ease without any extra keys, with a few advantages. The curves view allows you to select multiple keys and adjust all of their Bezier handles at once. This can be a big time saver when you want the same easing for many keys. Another advantage is that the curves view can save presets. This means you only need to do the tedious work of adjusting your handles once. Then you can save a preset and get the same curve whenever you need it. While you can set up curves by dragging handles in the graph and curves views, I recommend to always use keys for your anticipation and overshooting. That way, you can easily see the exact timing of your animation. If you need to make any changes, like for example a longer anticipation, you know exactly where to add more frames. The fastest way to add overshoot is again using the favor tool. We designed the tool so you can go beyond the end of the slider to add overshoot. Next, let's key something more complex so you can see how to apply easing efficiently. I made a rough squat animation with a pretty simple setup. Three keys in total: starting pose, anticipation, and the squat pose. I copied the pose from frame 25 to frame 35, so we have a 10 frame hold. Since all the curves are linear, the animation is very mechanical looking. Don't stop here. Select all the keys and change them to Bezier. This gives us easy easing, so we have eases at the start and the end of the transitions. The result is better, but still doesn't look great. Let's improve it by applying different types of keying techniques. I want more easing at the beginning of the animation. It is difficult to select and drag the many handles in the graph view. It's easier in the curves view, but still not really the result I want because the different parts of my character are all moving at the same speed. To get a more organic feel, I will create keys to define the easing of the different parts. Next, I need to go through the individual curves in the graph view. However, I don't want to spend time dragging handles around. I'm still in the blocking phase of animating, so I want to add the keys quickly and I will polish the curves later. To quickly edit the easing, I use the favor tool. Using hotkeys for the favor tool and curve types makes this process very fast. I added a key on frame 15. I want the leg to move faster than the body, so I will again use the favor tool to favor the leg on frame 25. And I will add a bit of overshoot with the body on frame 28. And define the ease at the end of the animation at frame 32. Now, let me show you why the curves view can be confusing if you don't also use the graph view. If you only look at the curves view, it's easy to think that you want easing at the beginning and the end of the transition from frame 25 to 28. However, when you look at the graph view, you can see that the Y motion will slow down to frame 25, then slowly speed up and slow down again to frame 28. This wrecks the arcs in your animation. To fix it, you can use an automatic Bezier curve, or if you really want to finesse it, you can drag the tangent handles. The curves view is convenient, but doesn't provide a good view of the entire animation, so be sure to also use the graph view. Now you can go through your curves and do any final polish to get the movement just right. This is a great time to experiment. This is only one example showing how I approach animating. There is no right or wrong way, but you can be efficient with your time and the number of clicks required and still make great animation. Be sure to explore all of Spine's tools individually and together. Each has strengths and weaknesses, depending on the use case. Different characters and different types of animation will require different keying techniques. So feel free to experiment and find the way that works best for you. Until next time, have fun and happy animating!